Today I'm going to share with you an incredibly simple technique to create a beautiful shallow depth of field effect in Photoshop, and the secret lies with just one key. So without any further ado, let's get started. So here we are in the magical world of Photoshop, and if you want to go ahead and download this photo or any other photos shown in the tutorial, you know what to do, check the links in the description. It's very easy, trust me. First of all, we need to determine the focal plane, or in other words, we need to determine which areas are going to be in focus. So in this case, have a look at it. Which areas are equidistant from the camera? Now, the way that shallow depth of field works in real life is that if you have a camera with a fast lens and you focus on the eyes, everything that is in that focal plane will be in focus. So if my eyes are here, so there will be an invisible focal plane imaginary from here, and anything I keep in this focal plane, any area, if I keep that pen in that focal plane, it will be in focus. This is just for demonstration. This area will be in focus. If the lens has a very shallow depth of field, have a look. We need to focus on this particular area. The nose will be a little out of focus, and also at the same time, a little bit of the body will be in focus. Not so much, not exactly on the focal plane, a little bit, a little further away. So we need to apply less blur on that one. So once we have determined which areas are going to be in focus, we can apply the blur accordingly. And this is absolutely non-destructive. So this was just for demonstration. I can just simply delete that, or you can just keep it. I'm just going to delete that. So first of all, what we do, we make a copy of the background layer. So with the background layer selected, press Ctrl or Command J to make a copy. You always want to work in a copy. You always want to have a backup. Now, once you have made the copy, you can go to Filter, and then convert for smart filters, and then hit OK. So that when you apply the blur, you can change the values later. Now you can name this shallow DOF, just for organization. And then go to Filter, Blur Gallery, and then Iris Blur. Now inside of that, there's a button that completely allows you to customize it. Just click on that one. It gives you a point. Let us take a moment and let us understand this. So first of all, let's increase the blur a little bit higher so that you'll be able to understand it more clearly. Now, if you look at it, it's very evident that in the middle, there is no blur, and outside of the circle, there's a lot of blur. What it exactly means is, if I just zoom in, have a look. So here is where the point starts. Now, around the point, there are four other points, right? If you bring them closer, that's where the blur is going to start, and it's going to keep on increasing till the boundary of this ellipse. Now let us use numbers to clearly understand this. So in the middle, no matter what, the blur will be zero. Absolutely zero. Now, as we move from the middle to one of these points, the blur will still be zero. Right? Now, from the point, let me just zoom out. From the point to the boundary of this ellipse, the blur will gradually increase from zero to whatever value you dial in. So in this case, I have dialed in 209. So the blur goes from zero to 209 right there. And outside of that boundary, it is 209. So it is, first of all, let me just change the value so that you can understand it better one more time. So value is now 100. Blur value is 100 pixels. So zero in the middle. It's going in and still zero, it's still zero. Once I reach the point, it's still zero. And from the point, it slowly and gradually increases from zero, maybe 20, 30, 50, 75, and then 100, or whatever value you have set there. That's how this works. Remember the focal plane that we just talked about, the areas which are going to be in focus? So we need to simply shape that ellipse around the area of focus. So let's make it a little narrower, move it up around the face. Of course, we don't need so much of a blur. First of all, let's keep it at around 5 pixels, that's fine. And now, let's keep it something like that. And let's make it even narrower from the sides. And by the way, you can rotate it. If you keep your cursor on the side and you click and drag, it will rotate that. Now, let's make it even narrower, just like this. Now, you can increase the blur as much as you want. Now, that was not the trick. So let's say I want a blur of 27, but it's also blurring the mouth. We don't want that. You want to be able to move these points accordingly, but if I move them, it's not in the shape of the face. What do we do? Here is the key secret. you need to press one key, and the name of the key is Alt on Windows, Option on Mac. Now, when you hold that key, have a look. You can individually move these points. Isn't that amazing? Now, you can just bring it here according to the area of focus that we just talked about. Bring it down like that. And now we have something going on, which is wonderful. Have a look at it. Isn't that beautiful? You can just adjust it accordingly. And there you have it. Now, you can increase as much blur as you want. Now, once you're done with it, the face is now in focus. But the problem is, a little bit of the body will be in focus too. Not exactly in focus, a little bit. Maybe a little less blur. So, what do? We create a point right there. Yes, you can create multiple points. Now, always keep in mind that in the middle, always in the middle, the blur will be zero. And here, we don't want a zero blur. So, what do? Let's zoom out. We move the point down below the image, and then we make it taller, just like this, just like the body. And we'll keep it something like that. Now, let's move these points in as well. And simply control the points according to the amount of blur you want there. So, we don't want it to be absolutely sharp. So, let's first of all keep it like this. I think this is okay. Now, once you're happy, you can always click OK. Now, have a look at this. Now, I have gone a little extreme just to show you the before and after more clearly. So, here is the before and here is the after. Amazing, isn't it? Now, you don't have to do too much. You can just double click on the blur gallery. You can always change the values. For this example, I'm going to go probably somewhere about 16 to keep it more realistic. And now when I look at it, I'm going to move these points even further like that. I think that's good. Hit OK once you're satisfied. There you have it. Shallow depth of field. Isn't that wonderful? Now, there's one more feature I wanted to show you. You can also combine different blur effects along with iris blur. And how do we do that? Let's move to example number two. Have a look at this example. In this image, both the face and a little bit of the hand are in the same focal plane. So, they will be in focus. Now, it might look a little tricky, but if we combine one more blur effect, it's going to be much easier and fun to do. So, with the background layer selected, as usual, press Ctrl or Command J. Now, let's name it Shallow DOF, Filter, Convert for Smart Filters, and then hit OK. And now what we do, we go to Filter again, Blur Gallery, and let's start with Iris Blur. We will do exactly the same as we did in the previous image, but also we want the hand in focus a little bit. So let's make one more point in here, and this time you might have to rotate it. So take the cursor to the side, click and drag it up to rotate, and then adjust the size. But the problem is, a little bit of her finger is also getting blurred, so we might have to increase the size from here, something like that. We might have to do that, even if we don't want to. We have to do it, and we need to blur it later by using some other effects. Now, let's adjust the points accordingly by holding the Alt key or the Option key. Keep in mind, we need to keep this in focus. We might have to increase the limit from here. That looks pretty okay. But you want to add some blur, because many of the areas are becoming in focus just because we are making the area bigger. No worries, there are more blur effects right here. So, what we can do, we can go to Field Blur. So, check this. Now, Field Blur allows you to create multiple points of blur, which is amazing. So, you need to bring the point right here, determine the amount of blur you want. So, here I want a little more blur. Maybe let's go for 30. I want a little blur here as well. Let's increase the value, 27. But this area needs to be in focus. So, I'm going to click a point right there and decrease the blur to 0. This area needs to be a little blurry. This area needs to be in focus. So, I'm going to decrease the blur to 0. Here as well, decrease the blur to 0. Now, here as well, on the nail tip, decrease the blur as well. On the face as well, we will simply decrease the blur. Now, have a look. With the help of Field Blur and Iris Blur combined, we have created a great shallow depth of field. If you want to add some extra blur, you can do that as well. Let's create one more point here and let's add some extra blur. And there you go. It's looking fantastic. Now, if you are interested, you can also use a little blur on the nose since it's protruding. You can do that, but it's totally upon you. I don't like to do it, but if you want, you can do that as well. To delete a point, make sure the point is selected and then press the delete key. It is deleted. Easy. And hit OK. And there you go. You have a very nice shallow depth of field portrait. Now, if I look at it again, a little bit area is still sharp. No problem at all. You can always go back to it. Double click on the blur gallery. No problem. Just create one more point in here and make sure the blur is a little high like that. And once you're satisfied with it, just hit OK. At this point, I might want to like decrease the blur. And OK. So that's a super simple way to easily apply the shallow depth of field effect in Photoshop. Let's do a quick little recap. First of all, determine the areas which are going to be in focus or in the focal plane. Secondly, apply iris blur. And you can use the Alt key or the Option key to adjust the points manually. And then if you want, you can also add some more blur effects in combination to it. You can add field blur. You can also try tilt shift blur, your choice. And you are pretty much good to go. And always do not forget that before applying the blur, convert the layer into a smart object so that you can change the values of iris blur or any blur that you apply later. I hope this tutorial helped you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tip, trick or tutorial. I would like to take this moment to thank all these nice and amazing people for supporting this channel on Patreon and helping keep PiXimperfect free for everybody forever. Thank you so much for all your support. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.